Hi, Geoff Lawton here. Permaculture is an ethical design science, and science is a body of known facts that we all rely on. Now, as designers, what we do is we see the patterns in those facts so we can put them together and harmonize design. As design consultants, we need to know everything we can about a site. And this is where mapping comes in. Apart from a location, its distance from the equator, north or south, its altitude and its distance from an ocean, the more we know about a site, the better we can design it. So if we look at high quality maps and we can see the strengths and weaknesses and limitations in a property, then we can really perform good quality design. In this video, I'm going to take you through our mapping process, which can be done better than ever before now, and we can do it remotely, anywhere in the world, in any location. We have three options to achieve our base foundation data. Number one, LIDAR. It definitely gives us the most detail, if it's available. Number two, satellite imagery, if it's available again, but it's the next best option. And number three, still pretty good, is a drone flight with a local operator and a very simple program. It's not too complicated. These will depict the physical objects found on the site. Every tree, every road, every building, every water course, every water body, and all the physical objects on site. This is how a digital map should be prepped for any designer. It's from here that we can see areas that are ideal for house sites, roads, food gardens, food forests, grazing area, farm forestry, and areas that are steep that need to be left as wilderness or created wilderness. It's from this that we can create cycles of abundance, where we can create ongoing fertility that will outlast us. Isn't this what everybody wants on land? Whether you're a permaculturist, whether you understand permaculture or not, this is what most of us actually want. Let me give you an example. Zaytuna Farm, my home and demonstration site to many. It's a 66-acre property. The satellite map has the full photograph, the aerial exact view of the landscape. It has the property lines, the roads, the buildings, the contour lines. It gives you the base details. The color elevation map gives you a sense of elevation across the site. The slope map, this is a very special map we've created. This gives you the degrees of slope across the site. So starting with the shallow slopes for gardens that don't need erosion control, then the slight slopes that you can garden and you have a little bit of erosion control required, going to the forest slopes where productive forestry can be engaged in, then to the grazing and farm forestry slopes, which are the medium slopes, to the steep slopes that should be retained as wilderness or allowed to become wilderness. So from this slope, we can see where we apply work. This gives us a real view of how we start to sensibly plan the landscape. We can also go from an individual property level to a community level, where at a greatly reduced cost per household, we can map a whole catchment. So the community understands the catchment island that it's sited in. So each person, each household has an understanding of the land use that's appropriate for a system that creates a stable, productive ecology within the region. This is where we really start to move forward with serious land restoration. In this part of the Shannon Valley, which encompasses 2,000 acres, we pulled the data with LIDAR and satellite imagery. And this is a demonstration of how water flows through each and every property in this part of the catchment. It's dubbed hydrostrobing. The ideal use of this technology is to map a whole community and link it to permaculture design, so everybody has this understanding of how together we can create a clean, healthy environment. To build a map of your own property or your community, head over to our website. And if you would like a permaculture consultancy, we have those services too. As always, feel free to leave a note below about what you've learned, what you'd like to learn in the future, and what you're excited about. And remember, enjoy the journey.